The name Tatnall is certainly synonymous with sprint car racing in Australia, and we have with us Brooke Tatnall, arguably Australia's best sprint car driver and certainly the best on paper in Australia. Brooke, great to have you on board. How's your summer been going?
Yeah, it hasn't been too bad. I mean, we've had a couple of, we had a strong start. We've had a couple of bad nights where, you know, we had one night we had a Magneto problem and we were in 14th. Then we've had a couple of nights where we've had some good results that were going to come our way, and we've had two cut down tyres, which has hindered us. But no, all in all, I mean, you know, you're never satisfied unless you win, you know, at least 99% of the races. So, yeah, race car drivers are never satisfied, and we'll keep pushing away for perfection.
So looking at East Coast Pipeline Speed Week, unfortunate last night. What happened there? Tell us a bit about that.
Just one of these deals. We got together with David Murcott, and it actually crushed the side right side nerf bar. As it bounced, it dug in the ground, and half of it broke off. I wasn't real happy with the call and the decision at the time, but looking at the rule book, it's a new rule that's been added. For many years, it's only been you only have to have a rear nerf bar to be able to restart. Side nerf bars didn't really matter. This year they brought in a new rule that you must have a side nerf bar. Well, my argument was I still have one, but it says it has to be 100% complete, and mine was broken. So, yeah, even though the decision went against us, my hat's off to the officials. They made the right call, and I think that, you know, the officials on World Series, Gary Pemberton, has done a good job, and they've been pretty consistent with their calls all year. And yeah, as I say, they made the right call, and I guessed it wrong. I keep telling them that's one up for the officials, but they won't get too many up on us.
Well, I suppose as long as it's consistent, isn't it? So the next time that happens to someone and they do the same, then it's okay, isn't it?
Well, yeah, exactly. And I mean, they have been consistent all year, so that, you know, you can't ask for anything more. I mean, it's a mug's job. No one wants to be the chief steward. Yeah. And as I say, these guys, you know, on World Series are running a very professional ship, and they're doing a very good job.
So last year, you were very dominant in Australia, winning the Classic and also World Series sprint cars. So this year, yet again, you're up running up front. What about another Classic this year, another World Series? Looking good for the cars?
Oh, we're definitely looking good for it. But, you know, with sprint car racing, anything's likely to happen and anything will happen. But, you know, we come back here each year with the same goals. We want to win World Series. We want to win the Warrnambool Classic. We want the Australian title. We want the Australian Open. And we want as many wins as we can possibly get. But, you know, last year we've dominated. This year, with World Series starting, you know, a little bit later, a week or two later, we haven't done quite as much racing this year, but no, we're still strong for it. Anytime you're putting your car in the top five and top three, night in, night out, you're putting yourself in a position to win, and that's where we've definitely been.
So looking back over your career, you were the first Australian to win a World of Outlaws event in America. Where does an Outlaws race sort of stack up, say, against an Australian title? Would you rate that above that?
I mean, it's two totally mixed bags. World of Outlaws races are very hard to come by. You know, there's no question, if you actually go through the record books, there's not that many guys that have won a lot of races and actually even claimed one victory with the World of Outlaws. So I mean, that's something that's up very high on the mantelpiece, but there's nothing that goes with the raw emotion and the sentimental value of an Australian title. I mean, you know, that goof that just walked past, he'll tell you it's the most important race in the world to win. He'll probably rather win 10 Australian titles than one Knoxville Nationals. But it's all horses for courses. As I say, you know, getting the very first Outlaw win in our career was something very important to me. And you know, I've always said I don't want to be the best in Australia. I want to be the best in the world.
Yep.
And you know, winning the Outlaw show is very, very tough. But as I say, 17 years to win an Australian title, you know, I wouldn't say they come easy either.
So looking back over this year, you came in unfortunately with an injury. Has that affected you much, or has it been slowly getting better?
I mean, look, I'm not going to make excuses for different things, but there have been nights that, yes, my leg has hurt me. It has hindered us a little bit. 9 times out of 10, I just say it doesn't affect us, but until you get out of the race car. But yeah, we've had a couple of nights here. This place here, it's in Toowoomba, they're both very, very demanding on how you drive the racetrack. You use a lot of brakes. This place gets a little rough, so you know, the bouncing around, you know, definitely, you know, makes it a little tougher on my leg. And I said to the guys last night, I said, hey, now I played it for a points percentage wise last night to keep us up front, and we'll throw all caution into the wind tonight and go and try and win this Australian Open.
So you're not forgetting about points tonight, it's really about trying to get that 20 grand and beating that Donny Shots guy?
That's the ultimate goal every night you race, but it's the nights when you turn around and you are off a little bit and you are sitting there back there running in a fourth or fifth spot. You've got to be smart about it. Toyota Genuine Parts World Series, it means a lot more than winning the Australian Open. Yep. To my bank manager, winning both is the most important thing right now. So now we're going out there, we're giving it our best shot. We still got a long way to go in this championship, but everyone's sort of focusing on points a lot, but we're only halfway through this championship, so there's a long way to go. There's a lot of wouldas, couldas and shouldas. And we had a 60 point lead over Fahey going into Warrnambool. We came out with 32. He went from third to second in that. So, we'll be smart with what we do, but no, we're here to win 20 grand.
So just moving away from the Australian scene now to America, I'm guessing you wanted to go back there this year. Any plans yet, or is it still up in the air a little bit?
We've got a race team sitting at our house right now, but the problem is we don't have a budget to race it. I've got a car owner that's given me a whole race team. I have everything at my disposal there, but I have to find the money to fund it. So, what we're trying to do, I'm trying to look at different ways of generating money. We've worked out, broken up different parts of the race car to try and get money together, and we're working hard at trying to find. We've got a spot for 9 sponsors that are all $1,500 sponsors. We're trying to hit up local businesses and Australian businesses.
Yep.
To try and when you add up all those little small spots, that adds up. Then we're trying to look at some $5,000 and $10,000 sponsors, and we are obviously looking for a $50,000 sponsor that'll get us going. I have a couple other people who I'm trying to get involved to partner up with me in this, and it'll, trying to make this a long-term goal. I'm sick and tired of going into deals that are one-year deals, and you never know what's going on from year to year. You can never build on a team, so that's why we're pushing very hard to try and make this happen.
Well, Brooke, thanks for your time. Good luck with getting that 20 grand tonight, and also keeping your bank manager happy, and also Toyota happy getting the series. And I'm sure we'll see you up the front tonight.
Yeah, we're definitely pushing hard. I know we've got the boss sitting the back over in WA, and he's been upbeat all year, keeping everyone pumped up. And we've got to step up the pacing. Yeah, pick up the wins too.
Well, there we have it, Brooke Tatnall, certainly Australia's most successful sprint car driver, and certainly looking to be $20,000 richer tonight. Thanks for watching.